Whether it's a joke, an opinion, or a new idea, humans share information. And we share different information in different ways depending on who we are and who we're sharing with. In college, you'll be asked to use scholarly sources. This refers to sources created by academics to share with other academics who study similar things. Scholarly sources are usually created by subject experts who study a narrow aspect of a broader issue. Scholars are often professors, graduate students, or professional researchers. Most have advanced degrees and have completed original research with a hyper-focused theme. If these sources seem hard to read, that's normal. They're not created for an undergraduate audience. When scholars want to share their work with other experts, they often create sources like peer-reviewed articles or books. Their peers, other professional researchers, read, respond to, and cite these scholarly works. Although communicating through articles and books might seem formal, scholarly publishing is a conversation between people who share an intellectual and professional stake in a complex issue. Academics might create and share scholarly sources in order to communicate original research findings, interpret or analyze evidence, critique or build on the ideas of others, suggest new ways of thinking or problem solving, and to demonstrate their expertise to keep or get a job. So, if you're asked to use scholarly sources for a paper or project, that usually means you're expected to attempt to understand the ideas and opinions of scholars and academics. You're being asked to practice the language and ideas of these subject experts. You're expected to support your arguments or conclusions with original research findings of experts, or your audience might find this type of source credible. Reading and interpreting scholarly sources can be hard, but it's supposed to be. Becoming familiar with the challenging language and content of scholarly sources will deepen your understanding of complex issues and information.